Here's a look at the Alberg 30 interior. The new cushions haven't come in yet. Now this is a removable insert boards to make a full bunk in the V berth, or lift it out for walkthrough style V berth. In this later model 1972 Alberg 30, the interior has a full fiberglass liner, so we removed all of it in the V-berth so we could build an integral water tank under the bunk here and make the lockers watertight, and the lids are above the water line. So this is the top of the water tank, and it's probably about 45 gallons, though we haven't filled it completely yet. There's a sight tube that we'll mark as we fill it so that you can see what's in there. And then all of these lockers are watertight as well on each side and forward. Got some plumbing that has to come through here. Chain locker drain goes underneath the water tank and the filler and the tank vent, and the chain locker is here. Got 150 feet of 5/16 G4 with 100 feet of nylon on the end, and the backing plates reinforce the bookshelves here. Strengthen the forward lower shrouds by fiberglassing them in completely to the deck and hull and to the bookshelf, and put in lighting outlets. Here's the clothes locker and the head. This has an airhead composting toilet. Like that. There's a handle here to turn the compost. Removable urine bottle in front. And it's got a vent that comes up here to a muffin fan with a solar vent, but it also has a switch here to turn on the fan for when the solar fan fails. And the medicine locker. The chain plates. And there's boxes for the terminal strips for the wiring. And these are the stainless steel ports, self-supporting. Used to have these fixed aluminum port lights here, so we scrapped three of them, and we moved this one up forward and put in the four opening ones. So there's hooks here to put a shower curtain up in each corner to close this off, and there's strips of wood on the floor here so that you can put a garden sprayer type shower in here, and it'll drain here to a sump box. Which is down here to pump overboard. Now you can see we've cut back the liner on the edges of the bilge area, and we re-glassed over the ballast because the old fiberglass is coming loose. And then coated it all with 2000E barrier coat, epoxy coating. And in the salon, we've reused some of the cabinetry, but we've modified it a bit to make storage lockers here and a nice usable shelf here with a high fiddle so you can stow things there. These are original at top. Just refinished those. And same on this side, we've got the dimmer control for the light. And it's good to have this portable fan clip-on bracket, as well as the fixed fans where you need them. And the dead lights, we threw out the aluminum frames and made mahogany trim for the inside, and then screwed the plexiglass, tinted plexiglass, 3/8 thick lenses over the side for new dead lights. And in the galley, put in a new sink, foot pump, a Rego stove, the gimbal mount, pick it up, set it down in its gimbals, perhaps otherwise in port, just to leave it down. Got a new seacock in there, and the drain for the sink shelf. Here we've tossed out the old dish locker face and put in these sliding 1/4-inch plexiglass panels here. And found a good place for the 800-watt inverter back here in the upper part of the dish locker out of the spray. And it can be hidden when you don't want to see it, but it's easily accessible. And the new switch panels. We got AC over here and then DC switches. Now these have 15-amp circuit breakers on them, and wherever we want lesser amperage breakers, we've installed the inline auto type fuses for sensitive low amperage loads like the GPS and compass light and the rest. So the AC is behind these covers, behind those covers. All the accessories of 12 volt come into these terminal strips from the outsides, and then the insides feed to the switch panel. And this is 12 volt positive bus, negative bus, inverter disconnect, battery disconnect. So here we've got the Garmin 740S, the touchscreen. It's on a swing out bracket, so you can use it out in the cockpit. I'm gonna keep it inside. And over here, the charge controller, solar charge controller. That's for those two solar trackers outside. They're about 55 watt each output. So we get about 6 amps when it needs it. And here's the standard Horizon Matrix. I believe it's a 2200 with the built-in GPS antenna, and it's AIS as well as VHF, so it can track shipping and sound an alarm. So this is the radio locker. And room to install some more, maybe a stereo system or an SSB radio can be put in here later. And the AC outlets. There's one there, and one in the forward cabin on different circuits, 30 amp total. The ice box here, we just converted it to a storage locker. And resurfaced countertops with Formica. And a compass serves as a telltale compass on the inside. Put in new handrails above and handrails at the companionway, and stainless steel tracks for the drop boards. under here, where the inboard engine used to be, now is a storage locker. Underneath this locker is four AGM batteries. Here's more storage back here for long items like the dinghy oars or an awning, and access there to the stuffing box of the rudder shaft. And then we sealed all this with more fiberglass and then 2000E epoxy coating. So there's the four AGM batteries and new seacocks. Cockpit lockers are watertight now, so the red handle is a drain valve for those. And plumbing for bilge pumps, and the shower sump can go down into the bilge aft of the batteries. And we filled in that narrow little slot in the keel just to make it easier to clean and strengthen it a bit. And there's the bilge with the small electric bilge pump with a electronic switch, and then the manual bilge pump pickup.